So what you had just referred to there was why people turned out in such numbers back in 2014. They wanted the right to directly elect their own leader rather than it being chosen by Beijing. Obviously that failed, and since then there have been a number of crackdowns on a political party was banned, candidates have been banned from running for office, and activists have been jailed, which is why now people are turning out in such numbers, because they say that this law, the extradition law, would be the biggest erosion of the freedoms that Hong Kong enjoys under one country, two systems.
And is there any sign that Carrie Lam might find some way of softening this bill to take the heat out of the protests?
So she has said that she's going to put in some broad safeguards, and more recently she said she'll put in a human rights safeguard that would be legally binding. But many people are saying that this actually just misses the point, because it's not about Hong Kong's legal system, which is one of the most respected in Asia, and Hong Kong has a very respected rule of law. It's actually on the receiving country, and that there's an expectation that on the receiving country people should have a fair trial and humane punishment, and that China just doesn't meet that threshold. This is what an expectation of what people should have, and that the worry is that those in Hong Kong, or those passing through Hong Kong, if they have a dissenting view about China, this law will be used to extradite them to the mainland China to face trial over there.
Now, quite understandably, a lot of us are focused on Carrie Lam. She's the chief executive. But what about all the members of the Legislative Council? Where do they stand on this?
So the Legislative Council is sort of split between two groups. You've got the pro-Beijing side and then the pan-democratic side, or the opposition side. And those pictures that you saw just there was the leader of the commission coming out and saying that he wanted this vote to happen next Thursday. And that has got the pan-democratic side quite up in arms, because they can't really understand why this is being rushed through so much. And also the pro-Beijing side, they've got the votes. If this was to be put to the vote, they would have the votes to push this through. So they really have the cards, and the Hong Kong government has the cards in their hands.
All of which is the reason why protesters are planning to come out on Wednesday. So how are preparations for what could be a large protest shaping up?
So people are gathering already. Two of the main protest sites have actually been closed down. One of them was because they're saying that it needs maintenance. But despite that, people are gathering. Thousands of police have been deployed, and many of the protesters are wearing white, which is a symbol of justice, but also a symbol of mourning in Chinese culture.